Hello and welcome. We are here talking about voltage taps on the primary of a transformer. So pretty common application in a, you know, step down transformer. Here I've got a, what would be a 600 volt would be my rated, down to 240 volt transformer. Now what we see here on the primary is we see these little taps with labels. Sometimes they're 3, sometimes they're 5, whatever they are. In this case, I've got a plus 5%, plus 2.5%, minus 2.5%, and a minus 5%. Now these are voltage taps. What's the purpose? Why are they there? Well, they are there in case my primary voltage isn't quite right. So this is a 600 volt primary. Well, what if I only had, 570 volts? What if I had 620 volts, right? If your primary voltage isn't right, your secondary voltage isn't right. So some transformers have these primary voltage taps so that we can adjust the voltage on the primary so that we still get our rated secondary voltage. So let's do some examples. So I've got this transformer. It's a 600 to 240 volt transformer. I need my 240 volt output. Let's say, you know, hey, we are super far away from the distribution transformer. Maybe we only have 585 volts, right? That's what I can get. I can only apply 585 volts. Oh man, that's not quite enough voltage. So what we want to do is we want to calculate what tap setting am I going to use in order to get my rated 240 volt output. There's one formula we're going to use for this. It is the tap percentage equals the actual voltage. In this case, we're doing 585 volts. That's our first example. Minus the rated voltage divided by the rated voltage. Okay. So for 585, what I'm going to do for my first example there, I'm going to go, you know, 585 volts minus 600 volts divided by 600 volts. Okay. That is going to give me negative 15 divided by 600 gives me a negative 2.5% tap. So if I were to connect my 585 volts up to negative 2.5%, I would get my rated output of 240 volts. So, well, that's great. That's all fine and dandy. But what if I had higher than rated voltage? Let's see if that formula works for that too. All right, so now we've got higher than rated voltage. Now let's say, you know, oh man, we got 630 volts. We're close to the distribution transformer. We got 630 volts. Let's see if we can apply the same formula. Okay, so I'm gonna go tap percentage equals 630 volts, my actual voltage, minus my rated 600 volts divided by rated. That's gonna give me an answer, you know, 630 minus 600, that's 30 divided by 600. That is going to equal positive 5%. So I can use my positive 5% tap. So that's 630 volts up there, right? And then we could fill in the other two here just by going, you know, 600, well, plus 2.5% would give me 615 volts. And then 600 minus 5%, just type that into our calculator, gives us 570 volts. So we can kind of fill out the rest of that chart there. So let me just wipe this off. All right, so we've done that. Now the cool thing with taps, right? Look, like I've said, I can take a different primary voltage, apply it to the transformer, still get my rated output. And of course, all the numbers we used here, they lined up perfectly. They're not always gonna line up in the real world. You know, maybe you have 581 volts. Well, you just pick the closest tap that works for you. Remembering it's probably good to be a little bit over than a little bit under on your secondary side. But when I'm working with these taps, it's important if, you know, I wanna change taps, something has happened in my building, I need to change taps, Typically, you want to de-energize the transformer. That's very important in order to keep it safe, so there's no big arcing or sparking. De-energize that transformer. Sometimes it's changing around leads or splices. Sometimes it's actually using a bolted connection and changing it. Sometimes there's like bars that you bolt in. Other times it'll actually just be a rotary dial that you can adjust. Now there is a couple as well that actually have automatic changers, so they'll monitor the secondary voltage and they'll change the tap accordingly. Those are quite a bit more expensive and a little bit fancier. But the last thing I want to talk about is a rating of these taps. So on these taps, there's actually going to be a rating. You'll see things, you might see F, C, B, N, or F, C, A, N. So those ratings will be right on the taps. Now what that stands for is full capacity below normal or full capacity above normal. What that's saying is if my voltage is low or my voltage is high, it's not going to change the capacity of the transformer. The VA rating will stay the same, which is great. What you want to watch out for is the label RCBN. Which means it is going to be reduced capacity if you use a tap. Reduced capacity below normal. It means if you apply a tap, your capacity changes accordingly. Right, so that's just a different way that they manufacture and that they rate that transformer. So reduced capacity below normal. You know, if I drop down to 2.5% tap here, if I tap down to that 585 volt 2.5, my VA is also going to go down accordingly. So lots of information there on voltage taps. I do hope that that helped. Thank you so much for watching. Take a look in the description below for a link to all my other transformers videos. I hope this one helped. Have a great day.